trade-in value, the best money back guarantee in the business. Here's why. Other jewelers hate our beautiful Anita diamond studs because ours are 100% eye flawless and near colorless. Beautiful stuff. They come complete with our 14-carat safety silicone backs, so that you never have to worry about losing them or outgrowing them, because our diamonds are such nice quality that we offer everyone a lifetime upgrade. You can trade in your Anita diamond studs and get exactly what you pay for them. I wish I could trade in my own eye diamonds at that trade. At the other corner of 8th and Lane, or online at nhtwentyeight.com.
German blade factory. Assessing over every detail means we're confident in offering 100% quality guarantee. Know that these guys have already made their case for Harry's, so thank you if you're one of them.
Right,
and if you're not, I'm going to give it to you with a special offer. Get a Harry starter set with a 5-blade razor, weighted handle, power gel, and a jacket.
For COVID-19 variants are now available. If you've had your primary series, schedule an updated COVID-19 booster appointment as soon as you're eligible. Sponsored by Pfizer and BioNTech.
Sure, we have 30 seconds to tell you the drivers who switched to Progressive because they're big. But then what? Radio. Say it was mine. So let's tell a story with sound effects.
Thank you.
Okay.
the Capital Three guy. their lives in my department, and then I'm sure I know I'm going to win my bet. It's been called a comeback for the ages. Justin Verlander has nabbed his third Cy Young Award, this one as a Houston Astro. This, after recovering from one of the most dreaded surgeries a pitcher can have. Verlander had Tommy John surgery in September of 2020. He missed all of 2021 recovering. This season, Verlander led all of baseball with a 1.75 ERA, which is the best mark for a 39-year-old pitcher since Cy Young himself. So pretty cool for him.
Yeah.
Yeah, the thing about that surgery is you come back and then it's like your arm is like a young arm again. You know, so you throw harder and
you got like a Terminator on?
A little bit.
Wow.
Well, they rebuild it.
That's pretty amazing.
Mm-hmm.
I heard pickleball is big, so much so that Stephen Colbert is hosting Pickles, a celebrity pickleball. Because of the games caught on, there's been a huge spike in the popularity of pickleball.
Yeah.
That's why there's so many more pickleball injuries.
Bird? No,
conspiracy theories. The other night on Inside the NBA, Shaquille O'Neal came up with a new classic. There's more than one meme. The other day I was riding and the moon was on the left and I kept going straight, didn't make any turns. About 20 minutes later, the moon was behind me.
Sure, it's an awesome direction.
Charles Barkley interrupted and said,
"It's because it was moving, fool."
But Shaq wasn't deterred. He said, "There's more than one moon." And then another 45 seconds, the moon is on my right. There's more than one moon, people, believe it or not.
I think he doesn't understand how directions work.
I don't think he does,
That changed history. They're like, this is the day that Shaq realized it was coming.
Speaking
of old disgusting burrs, Spacey.
and has been accused of 7 more sex offenses in the UK, on top of the 5 he already faces, and this is all while he was artistic director of London's Old Vic Theatre. The Hollywood star and 63-year-old Oscar winner, who starred in House of Cards and the film American Beauty and Usual Suspects, will be charged by the Crown Prosecution Service with a number of sexual assaults against one man between 2001 and 2004. Charges include 3 counts of indecent assault, 3 counts of sexual assault, and 1 count of causing a person to engage in sexual activity without consent. Kevin Spacey will appear in court next month in the UK to face these charges. It sucks that this guy's a perv. It really does. Why does it suck so much? Because you think he's a good actor?
Yeah, because he was great. But he's just a perv, and his pervness.
One. It just sucks that it, like, ruined stuff that I liked for a long time.
Yeah.
Now it's like I can't watch any of some of what I used to consider my favorite movies.
Right, because it all paints just like an idea.
Spacey denies these offenses. He is expected to face a 3 to 4 week trial next June in the UK.
Now, he keeps getting off of these things. I'm going to be, I don't know what to do.
Like, if he keeps, like, beating all these charges, you know?
And how many of them didn't the person that was accusing him disappear or die?
Yeah, that was at least one.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, there was a gay mafia.
I believe
there was a gay mafia that was a gay star about to play. High power gay.
Yeah.
Jay Leno's doctor said the comedian is in good condition now after sustaining third-degree burns in a freak accident over the weekend. Dr. Peter Grossman said in a press conference that the former Tonight Show host has already undergone 1 surgery, a skin grafting procedure, but he'll have to undergo at least 1 more by the end of this week. They say his injuries are serious, but his condition is good, and he did well during the first surgery. He's in good spirits today. The physician also shared that while residing at the Grossman Burn Center, Jay Leno has been passing out cookies and stuff to people. And we're very happy to have him here.
There's no painfulness. Let's look at one of those painful
right. You can burn yourself a little bit on your finger or something. Yeah. You know how much that hurts, but remember the one side of your face.
The surgery is
terrifying. Jane Fonda says at 84 years old, she knows she doesn't have much time left, and she's ready to go.
Really?
She says, I'm ready to die. A lot of, like, really elderly people feel that way. Like, they're like, hey, just, you know, every day I wake up, I wasn't expecting it.
I just feel like 84 isn't there yet. I wouldn't be there yet. She's in pretty decent health, right?
Yeah, she's still there.
So I think she has going through something. I think she has diagnosed with non-Hodgkin's lymphoma.
That's right, yeah.
Back in September.
Oh, maybe that's like...
But it's going well, but still, like, I think she's like, all right, if I go, I go.
Okay.
Oh, see, like, if I'm fighting something like that, I don't put the other side of it into the universe, right?
Right. But she's 84, and she's like, well, this is what she said. She said, I'm just being realistic about my future.
I know there's more time behind me than ahead of me, and I'm not going to be around much longer. She said, I had a great life. When you get to be my age, you better be aware of the amount of time that's behind you as opposed to in front of you. It's just realistic.
Yeah.
I'm not afraid of going, she says. I'm ready. I've had a great life. Not that I want to go, but I'm aware that it's going to be sooner rather than later.
Yeah, it's like not like she wants.
Yeah, that's a healthy,
like that's healthy,
mentally healthy way to do it.
And she seems like a very mentally healthy person, right?
Yeah.
Like in any interview I've done, she's still with it. She's still, you know, seems like everything's going well.
Well, if someone in your life has been very upset the past few days, kind of like we've been dealing with here with Chuck, it's because they haven't been able to get their hands on a Taylor Swift ticket.
Mm. I've tried 4 times.
This is not a part of my world with 2 boys. I don't know what's going on here, but I've just heard it's been an effing nightmare for people who've been trying to buy tickets to Taylor's upcoming tour. Here's a little report on what's been going on here.
Never got tickets after trying for hours.
I am back to crying again because I'm so upset. This woman ended up with nosebleed seats after a 5-hour wait. I'm here for a cry. I am sorry. I can't do it.
scan?
Is that a line?
I've spent my whole day from 10 a.m. until this point. Tickets, tickets to see Taylor Swift. And my line decided to disappear.
It also happened to this mom and daughter. How frustrated are you?
It was bad.
Yeah, we're definitely frustrated with the fact that we had gotten to, like the first place, but then it just didn't happen.
Look, here they are, next in line. Then suddenly they're behind.
I'm actually really surprised that Ticketmaster wasn't a little bit more prepared.
Ticketmaster issued this statement. There has been historically unprecedented demand, with millions showing up to buy tickets for Swift's tour, which had caused intermittent issues. And his George Stephanopoulos can relate to all the chaos.
What a text I got yesterday. The ticket price was $55,000. And I just wrote back again.
He's not joking. I tickets retailing today for $45,000. I tried to buy Las Vegas for the next wave of pickup tickets and send it to Canada. So the interruption, there's something technical.
Literally here, you got, what, 20 million people trying for 200,000 tickets of a port.
That's the problem, and I think that you can.